Hey guys, in this video we will see platelet plaque formation. We know that platelet plaque formation is one of the mechanisms of hemostasis along with vasoconstriction and blood coagulation. Let's say this is a blood vessel in your hand. This is its endothelium and this is collagen underneath it. Under physiological condition, platelet plaque formation is prevented by endothelial cells. But unfortunately you injured your hand. It damaged the endothelial cells of your blood vessel and exposed the collagen underneath it. This will now trigger platelet plaque formation. So let's see how it is formed. The damaged endothelial cells release one Willebrand factor. It binds with collagen that is exposed to the blood. Now in blood we have platelets that are flowing closer to the vessel wall. They have glycoprotein 1b, glycoprotein 1a2a, and glycoprotein 6 on their surface. Through these receptors, platelet attaches to the exposed collagen. Glycoprotein 1b binds via one Willebrand factor and glycoprotein 1a2a and glycoprotein 6 bind directly with collagen. Likewise, more platelets come and cover the damaged area. This is called platelet adhesion. Now the next step. Binding of these receptors activates the platelet. Platelets have storage vesicles like alpha and dense granules. Upon activation, content of these granules are released into the surroundings. Content of alpha granules include various growth factors which will carry out wound healing. One Willebrand factor which contributes in platelet aggregation. Fibrinogen which contributes in aggregation as well as coagulation. And factor 5 which contributes in coagulation. Content of dense granules are ADP which helps in platelet aggregation, serotonin which causes vasoconstriction, and calcium which contributes in coagulation. Among these, fibrinogen and ADP play important role in platelet aggregation. We will come to them later. First let's complete what else is going on in activated platelet. From the membrane phospholipid of activated platelet, cyclooxygenase and thromboxane synthase start producing thromboxane A2. It is also released into the blood. Parallel to all this, thrombin is generated on platelet surface as a result of activation of coagulation cascade. It also joins ADP and thromboxane A2. Next, activated platelets undergo change in shape. They extend finger-like projections which increase surface area of platelets. Lastly, activation of platelets cause conformational changes in its surface receptor glycoprotein 2b3a. Which is now capable of binding with fibrinogen. So these were the things happening in activated platelet. Now let's move to these molecules. They help in recruiting more platelets from circulation. Circulating platelets have receptors like P2Y12 for ADP, thromboxane A2 receptors for thromboxane A2, and protease activated receptor 1 for thrombin. When activated by their respective ligands, these receptors cause activation of platelet. This activated platelet undergoes almost all the processes that we saw for this one, like conformational changes in glycoprotein 2b3a, which binds with fibrinogen bound to already activated platelet. See, fibrinogen is working as bridge between two platelets here. Similarly, one Willebrand factor also serves as bridge to connect platelets. The activated platelet undergo change in shape and also release more ADP, thromboxane A2 and thrombin to recruit even more platelets. Again, the ligands bind to their respective receptors, causing platelet activation, followed by activation of glycoprotein 2b3a, binding with other activated platelet and change in shape. In this way, platelets are recruited till the wound is plugged. This is called platelet aggregation. Plug thus formed is called primary hemostatic plug or primary platelet plug. It quickly sees the break in vasculature, but it is comparatively weak. Fibrin synthesized at the end of coagulation cascade strengthens this plug and now it is called secondary plug. So this was about platelet plug formation. Now let's have a quick summary. Injury to the vessel damages endothelial cells which release one Willebrand factor which binds with the collagen. Platelets adhere to the damaged site by glycoprotein 1b which binds with the one Willebrand factor and glycoprotein 1a2a and glycoprotein 6, which binds with collagen. This causes activation of platelet. Activated platelets release alpha and dense granules. Alpha granules have growth factors which help in wound healing. One Willebrand factor helps in platelet aggregation. Fibrinogen contributes in aggregation as well as coagulation, and factor 5 in coagulation. Dense granules release ADP, which helps in aggregation. Serotonin causes vasoconstriction, and calcium helps in coagulation. Also, activated platelets release thromboxane A2, synthesized by cyclooxygenase and thromboxane synthase. Parallelly occurring coagulation cascade on platelet surface produce thrombin. Platelet changes shape to increase its surface area. And finally, conformational changes in glycoprotein 2b, 3a, which can then bind with fibrinogen. Next step is platelet aggregation. Here, more platelets are activated by ADP, which binds with P2Y12, thromboxane A2, which binds with thromboxane A2 receptor, and thrombin, which binds with protease activated receptor 1. The activation causes conformational changes in glycoprotein 2B3A, which then binds with the fibrinogen. Here, fibrinogen and one Willebrand factor work as bridge between platelets. These activated platelets also release more ADP and thromboxane A2 to activate even more platelets and so on. In this way, primary platelet plug is formed, which is further stabilized by coagulation. That's it, friends, for this video. If you are a visual learner and like learning this way, please check out more videos at our channel. And don't forget to subscribe, because lots more to come. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.